I just think it's pretty bad to be disrespected.
While we're here, just
here, now.
Wait! City! Where's Mr. Chuck? You okay with everything?
I'm okay right now.
Okay. Maybe just for clarification for the people here, Mr. Chow. Are you still the acting director or are you the director?
I am the director.
Okay, so you're the man now.
Okay.
Director of Aboriginal Relations, City of Edmonton. Park. Okay. Aboriginal and?
Multicultural.
Okay. So there we are. We have some witnesses. We've done what we had to do here. We've marked. But Sudana says, that's my name.
Most likely somebody's gonna come and tear this thing down, break it down. Because that's what they did over there. Put that spear and cross up 3 times. And every time it went up, it got stronger. The site got stronger. So if this thing is broken down, it's the end for the other guys. Because they cannot eat what's in the ground. That's the problem.
Something of Alberta, the City of Edmonton, does not recognize the Indian religion. It is not recognized. It's not legal in the Alberta legislature. It's not legal in the House of Commons. I am a shaman, a priest, under 176 of the human code. I am exercising my rights for thousands of years. My lineage has not changed. Today, the government and the city do not respect or acknowledge legally the right to have sunlight. My right, if I want to have a sundance down here again, the last one is hell. Here, 1908. The last one is hell. Think about that. It's becoming real.
He as a person, as an AT person, AT psychologist who worked with First Nations. Hard to realize that, you know, in terms of fire, hard to the fire is great. In terms of sound, great place. But most important, the First Nations people have access. You know, people live just on
the street.
On 107th Street, you can walk to the site. And a lot of people, sometimes 20, 22 people here. Because of access to the building. And you know, you want to put us in the river valley 3-4 miles away. You don't realize there is fire there. And if that's my watch, I thought, on fire, sometimes I can't have it. It moves a big part of the river valley. This is actually the best part. And because of the history here, you know, right across the river, you're probably aware they're going to have an arch over there.
For both.
You know, that would be overlooked, you know?
I mean, why shouldn't we be able to talk here or in other towns? Because that is who we are. We don't build churches because our sweat lodge is our church. This is our church. We got to meet somewhere, and outside is our church. Outside is where we feel human. Like, putting us into jails or into houses is not who we are, because it makes us claustrophobic. It takes who we are, because we're open, free. Don't know how to say it. We're free living souls. Like, and every time a tree or a structure like this, we work, we thrive. Like, and every time we've got to come to one of these, yes, we come a bit of anger, but it's anger's more frustration than anything, because every time something like this happens, it tears us apart, like, because we're losing, again, another piece of who we are, our culture, our identity, and we're not that people, but everybody just thinks that native tribe, we like this, well, where are we like this, go back into history, for one, we never had that, ever, drugs. It's not a native thing. Drugs have become a settler making meth in their own homes and selling it to people. like the addictions are set to people who have been forced to be victims, and then they get to give people strength and to find themselves and everything that they need, and giving them a place to go that's safe. Like, I went down to the Bristol, and there's the veteran that served the war and the bombs and the guns and everything he used to test about him. What he was doing. And we're told it. Like, I mean, we've got to really start building, like, friendships. Really fighting for it. Honestly. Culture can make their disease or their dirty because they're not. We are the most loving, caring people ever. It's just, you gotta understand that every time that we're pushed or called or something's taken away, well, that's ripping at us, that's making us feel, well, we're going back to that time that you tell us we have to rise up, we have to get above that, but how can you guys continue to take everything away from us? And please, do not let this go, because we would not put it worse than this, we would not demolish it, we would not put structures and houses and escorts, you know? Like, you gotta think. Common sense is, if you don't like it, why would you, you know? Why would you come onto our land and destroy what we have, but yet we cannot do that to you? It's that back and forth, and that's what this I don't know more, that's why all of us are standing up. Like, I don't know more, for me, is because I can't stand by and watch all this disappear. You know, my kids don't even believe me. They're like, are you Indian? What are you talking about? No, you're not Indian. You're First Nation, you know? But they have none of that, not even in their schools. My one daughter goes to no school. But yet there is no culture based in that school except for the government's ways. Like, no elder teaching, no elder counseling, you know? Like, everything is just being torn. Like, we have lots of elders who would love to come into these schools, get jobs, teach our youth, you know? Like, but all that's coming out of schools is more ignorance. Like, this is the struggle I see in Blackfoot. And, well, everybody does. It's not just the me thing. It's an everybody thing. And then, we don't want to be angry or anything, but it does.
Well, it's okay to be angry first. You have to be angry first for nothing to happen. I think you have every right to be okay